Hello everyone. Today we will be continuing study of bridge engineering. Section 1. Calculation of deck arch bridges. The calculation of ordinary deck arch bridges, which are multiple statically indeterminate space structures. In fact, there is the joint action of the building on the arch and the main arch, but in order to simplify the analysis, it is generally safe not to consider it. In the transverse direction of the bridge, whether the live load acts on the center of the bridge deck or not, there will be uneven stress distribution on the cross section of the bridge. When the building on the arch is bent, the transverse non-uniform distribution of live load should be considered. The building on the arch is a transverse wall type plate arch. This effect is generally not considered for hyperbolic arch and box arch. The transverse distribution of live load should be considered for both rigid frame arch and truss arch. Establishment of arch axis equation. Solid web catenary arch. The solid web catenary arch adopts the structure dead weight pressure line as the arch axis. The structural dead weight of solid web arch includes the dead weight of arch ring, arch filler, and bridge deck. Its distribution is shown in the figure. The arch axis equation of solid web catenary arch is derived under the action of the dead weight of the structure, as shown in the figure. Based on the condition that the arch axis is completely consistent with the press line, take the coordinate system as shown in the figure and set the arch axis as the structural dead weight pressure line. Therefore, under the action of the dead weight of the structure, the bending moment of the arch top section MD equals zero and the shear force QD equals zero due to the symmetry. Therefore, the arch cross section only has structural dead weight stress HG. Take the moment of the arch foot section, then the following results are obtained. The above formula is the basic equation for calculating the dead weight pressure line of the structure. Calculate the second derivative of x on both sides of the above formula and get the following results. The above formula is the basic differential equation for calculating the dead weight pressure line of the structure. In order to obtain the general equation of the arch axis, it is necessary to know the distribution law of the dead weight of the structure. It can be seen from the figure that the structural dead weight concentration Gx of any point can be expressed by the following formula. The following results can be obtained from the above formula. The following results can be obtained from the above formula. Then substitute the above formula into the basic differential equation and introduce the parameters. The following results can be obtained. The above formula is a second-order non-homogeneous linear differential equation with constant coefficients. By solving this equation, the arch axis equation is as follows. The above formula is generally called catenary equation. For solved sections, cosine equals 1, y1 equals f. Substituted into the above formula, the formula results are obtained. Generally, m is a known value, then the value of k can be obtained from the following formula. When m equals 1, then gx equals gd, indicating that the dead weight of the structure is a uniformly distributed load. Substitute m equals 1 into the above equation, and after solving the differential equation, it can be seen that the pressure line on the uniform load is a quadratic parabola, and its equation is. It can be seen from the catenary equation that when the right span ratio of the arch is determined, the longitudinal coordinate of each point of the arch axis will depend on the arch axis coefficient m. M depends on the ratio of dead load concentration between arch foot and arch column. The arch axis coordinate y1 values of various m values can be directly formed in the appendix of the design manual for highway bridges and covered arch bridges. The determination of the arch axis coefficient of solid white catenary arch is introduced below. Because m equals gg/gd, it can be seen from the figure that the dead load concentration at the arch column is as follows. At the arch foot, Hg equals Hd at h. Its dead load concentration is as follows. It can be seen from the formula that in these two formulas, phi g is an unknown number and the rest are known numbers. Because phi g is unknown, so the value of m cannot be calculated directly, and it needs to be determined by successive approximation method. Assuming the m value based on the span and rate, the cosine at the arch foot can be obtained from the attached table of the arch bridge. The value of cosine phi g is obtained by substituting it into the equation to obtain gg, and then substituting it with gd to obtain the value of m. Then compare with the assumed m value. If the calculated m value is consistent with the assumed m value, then the assumed m value is the true value. If they do not match, the calculated value of m should be used as the assumed value and recalculated until the two are close. When the span and the rate of the arch are determined, the shape of the catenary depends on the arch axis coefficient m, and its linear characteristic can be shown in the figure by using the size table of 1/4 point ordinate yl/4, the longitudinal coordinate yl/4, and m of the 1/4 point of the arch span have the following relationship. When cosec equal 1 slash 2, it is known that y1 equal 1 l slash 4. The following results are obtained by substituting into the formula. From the above formula, y1 slash 4 decreases with the increase of m and increases with the decrease of m. When m increases, the x-axis rises. On the contrary, when m decreases, the x-axis decreases. In general, catenary bridges, the structural deck weight increases from the crown to the foot. Only under uniformly distributed load, the result is m equal 1. The following result can be obtained from the formula. In this case, the relationship between GG, GD, m, and x-axis coordinates is shown in the figure. The corresponding relationship between them is shown in the following table. Open web catenary arch. In the open web arch bridge, the structural dead weight of the span structure can be divided into two parts, namely the distributed force of the dead weight of the main arch ring and the solid web section and the concentrated force transmitted by the open web section through the web pair. In order to make the catenary arch axis close to the structural dead weight pressure line, the five-point weight method is generally used to determine the m value of the catenary arch axis, that is, the arch axis is required to have 5 points in the whole arch to coincide with the corresponding 3-hinged arch structure dead weight pressure line. Therefore, the value of m can be determined according to the condition that the bending moment at the above 5 points is 0. According to the symmetry condition of zero bending moment of the arch crown and the structural dead weight, the arch crown only has the structural dead weight thrust Hg passing through the center of gravity of the section. The corresponding bending moment Md equals 0. And the shear force Qd equals 0. In the figure, from sigma ma equals 0, the following results are obtained. From sigma mb equals 0, the following results are obtained. When the following is brought in, the following result can be obtained. The bending moment m1/4 and mg of the main arch ring structure of the constant section catenary arch against 1/4 and the arch foot section can be found in the attached table of arch bridge. After obtaining y1/4/f, m can be inversely obtained from the above formula, namely, the m value of the hollow arch bridge is still determined by the successive approximation method, that is, assuming a value of m, determine the arch axis, draw a drawing to arrange the buildings on the arch, and then calculate the moment of the structural dead weight of the arch ring and the building on the arch to L/4 and the arch foot section sigma m 1/4 and sigma m0. Calculate y1/4/f according to the formula. Then use the formula to calculate the value of m. If it is inconsistent with the assumed value of m, take the calculated value of m as the new assumed value and recalculate until the two values are close. According to the structural mechanics, the redundant force at the elastic center caused by the load acting on the basic structure is as follows. It can be seen from the figure that the y has positive and negative values, and the value of integral along the whole arch is small. According to the formula, the x1 is small. If the integral is equal to 0, the x1 equals 0. According to the calculation, the x2 determined by this formula is always positive. The deviation bending moment of any section is the following result. For arch crawl and arch foot sections, MP equals 0, and the deviation bending moment is the following result. The arch axis determined by the five point weight method for the open spandrel non-arch bridge coincides with the structural dead weight pressure length of the corresponding three hinge arch at the arch crown to 1/4 pounds and 2 arch feet at 5 pounds. Well, there is no 5 pound coincidence relationship with the structural dead weight pressure length of the non-hinged arch. From this formula, it can be seen that because the arch axis deviates from the structural dead weight pressure length, the deflection bending moment is generated at the arch crown and arch foot. The research shows that the deflection moment occurs at the arch crown and arch foot due to the deviation of the arch axis from the structural dead weight pressure length. The research shows that the deviation moment of the arch crown is negative, while the deviation moment of the arch foot is positive, which is just opposite to the sign of the control moment of the two sections. This fact shows that in the open spandrel arch bridge, the deflection of the catenary arch axis determined by the five-point method is beneficial to the arch crown and arch foot. Therefore, it is more reasonable to use catenary for the arch axis of open web non-hinged arch than to use structure dead weight pressure length. Horizontal inclination of arch axis phi. Tell the formula cosine. Take the derivative and get the following result. Because bring the formula in and get the following result. It can be seen from the above formula that the horizontal inclination of the arch axis is related to the arch axis coefficient m. Horizontal inclination tangent of each point on the arch axis phi. The value can be found directly from the attached table of arch bridge. Elastic center of catenary without ammonium arch. As shown in the figure, under the action of load, taking the half arch cantilever as the basic structure. Three redundant forces, x1, x2, and x3, will be generated at the arch coron. The typical equation is as follows. The bending moment x1 and the axial force x2 in the redundant force are positive symmetry, and the shear force x3 is anti-symmetric, so we know that the auxiliary coefficient is as follows. But there are still delta 12 equals delta 21, not equal to 0. If we can manage to delta 12 equals delta 21, it also equal to 0, then all the side coefficients in the typical equation are 0. Then the problem of solving the simultaneous equation becomes the problem of solving three independent, univariate, linear equations, thus the calculation can be simplified. We are talking about symmetric arches, and the elastic center is on the axis of symmetry. There are two ways to choose the basic structure, cantilever curved beam as the basic structure in the figure, and simply supported curved beam as the basic structure. The cantilever curved beam is taken as the basic structure as shown in the figure. According to the calculation, the internal force caused by the three redundant forces acting on the elastic center is the following formula. When the unit force acts separately, where the x-axis is positive to the left and the y-axis is positive downward, the bending moment is positive to make the lower edge of the arch tensioned. The shear force is positive when it rotates counterclockwise around the isolation body, and the axial force is positive when it is pressure. The right half arch is positive and the left half arch is negative. Therefore, order delta 12 equal delta 21 equal 0, then the distance from the elastic center to the vault is as follows. Among them, so substitute y1 and ds into the formula, and note that I in the arch with constant section is constant. Then the coefficient alpha, it can be seen from the table in arch bridge. Example, for a hingeless arch bridge, the calculated span is L. The dead weight of the main arch ring and the building structure on the arch is simplified to the load action shown in the figure. The section area of the main arch ring is A. The weight is gamma. Try to use the 5-point weight method to determine the arch axis coefficient M of the arch bridge and calculate the vertical force of the arch foot VG, the horizontal thrust HG, and the structural self-weight axial force NG. Solution. Take the cantilever curved beam as the basic structure as shown in the figure. Because the structure is positive symmetric and the load is positive symmetric, the redundant force at the elastic center x3 equals 0. There are only the positive redundant force x1, x2. The following formula is obtained from the simultaneous solution of the two formulas. It can be seen from the figure that the bending moment of the concentrated load of the half arch cantilever on the arch span 1/4 section and the arch foot section is as follows. Assume that the arch axis coefficient m, because f/l equals 1/5. According to the attached table of arch bridge, the bending moment of the cantilever weight of the half arch on the 1/4 section and the arch foot section is as follows. So, the bending moment of the cantilever load of all half arches on the 1/4 section and the arch foot section is as follows. So, therefore, M and M top set do not match and need to be recalculated. Assumed arch axis coefficient M. According to the attached table of arch bridge, the bending moment of the cantilever weight of the half arch to the 1/4 section and the arch foot section is as follows. The bending moment of the cantilever load of all half arches on the 1/4 section and the arch foot section is as follows. So the difference between M and M top set is less than half level, so the arch axis coefficient is taken as M. According to the attached table of arch bridge, the vertical shear force of the cantilever weight of the half arch on the arch foot section is as follows. The vertical shear force of the concentrated force of the half arch cantilever on the arch foot section is as follows. The total vertical shear force of the cantilever load on the arch foot section is the following result. The self-weight axial force of the arch foot section structure is the following result. Okay, that's all for today. Please take an active part in other teaching sessions after class.